childhood nutrition and educational outcomes, evidence drawn from the first four waves of the National Income Dynamics Study. There is increasing evidence that suggests that the early life circumstances of a child can have a significant impact on their later outcomes in life. Because NIDS follows the same South Africans over time, the NIDS data provides researchers and policymakers with a unique opportunity to investigate the effects of early life circumstances on later life outcomes. In this video, we explore evidence from NIDS, which assesses the impact of early childhood health by way of childhood nutrition on educational outcomes, which are measured in terms of school performance. A child's performance during their schooling years affects their chances of completing grade 12. This, in turn, affects their chances of obtaining post-secondary education and, by extension, entering the labor market. Therefore, improving early childhood nutrition can potentially play a critical role in helping children achieve their full potential and become productive adults. Looking at evidence of poor childhood nutrition in South Africa, we focus on two forms of poor nutrition in childhood, namely stunting, which is defined as low height for age, and obesity, which is measured by high body mass index, or BMI. Looking at children aged 6 months to 14 years in the 2008 NIDS data, African and colored children were far more likely to be stunted or severely stunted, 18% and 20% respectively, than Indian and white children, 11% and 7% respectively. Similarly, rates of obesity were also highest among African and colored children at 7% and 14% respectively, compared to 2% of Indian children and 6% of white children. It is, however, worth noting that the sample sizes for Indian and white children from which these percentages were calculated are very small. In examining the effect of early childhood nutrition on educational performance, we looked at African and colored children who were aged 0 to 8 years in 2008 and 7 to 14 years in 2014/15 in the NIDS data, and compared the educational performance by 2014/15 with their nutritional status in 2008. Three main factors were used to measure educational performance: the age the child started grade 1, the number of grades the child had completed by 2014/15, and whether the child passed, failed, or withdrew before completing the grades they had enrolled in. Whilst nutritional status was evaluated using measures of stunting and obesity. When children who were stunted in 2008 were compared with their non-stunted counterparts, it showed that they had started school later, had completed fewer years of schooling by 2014/15, and had progressed through school at a slower rate than their non-stunted peers, even when compared with those who started school at a similar age. This could reduce their potential lifetime earnings if they then graduate later. Furthermore, children who were stunted in 2008 were also more likely to come from poor households and live in rural areas. The negative relationship between stunting and education remains, even when taking this into account. Interestingly, however, childhood obesity was not found to significantly impact educational performance. The negative impacts of stunting on educational performance raise the following important questions. How can stunting be addressed prior to children starting school in order to avoid bottlenecks in the schooling system? What kind of support do stunted children need to give them the best chance of success alongside their peers? Can caregivers, schools, and communities be better supported through improved nutritional education? This video was drawn from the National Income Dynamics Study, which is an initiative of the Department of Planning, Monitoring and Evaluation. The study has been following the lives of 28,000 South Africans since 2008, and in so doing has been collecting a huge amount of data every 2 years. It's designed to help facilitate the development of better policy informed by better research. It's available and it's free. Find us at www.nids.uct.ac.za. The National Income Dynamics Study, telling the stories of the people of South Africa.